In this video, I will explain the math behind illusions and Jidora's quests. I will start with a very brief overview of how questing works, and then I will cover how to calculate your chances of success and average profit margins. When you decide to quest, you have two options, illusion or Jidora. The basics are the same for each fairy. You have 16 and a half minutes to complete each level, after which you must wait 12 hours before starting the next level. If you fail a quest at any point, you will have to start over at level 1. The quests begin with low rarity items and will ask for progressively rarer items as you advance. Eventually, the fairies will ask exclusively for rarity 99 items. The majority of these items are not available through the shop wizard, which is why access to rarity 99 collections are essential to completing these higher levels. The top prize for each fairy is awarded upon completion of level 50, and each one sells for tens of millions of Neo points. Being able to reliably quest these top prizes allows rarity 99 collectors to turn a profit. Before we begin the calculations, there are two assumptions I want to lay out. First, I'm going to assume the lower levels are trivial to complete, so I will focus on the rarity 99 levels only. That means my calculations will begin at level 35 for Illusion and level 28 for Jidora. Second, I will assume your own Rarity 99 collection is the only resource you have. In reality, there's a good chance you'll find a seller through the trading post or the forums, but it's difficult to quantify how much that affects your chances, so I won't be including it in my calculations. We'll start with the probability of completing a single quest. Given the entire pool of Rarity 99s, we need the fairy to pick an item that we own. So the chances of completing a single quest is just the ratio of Rarity 99s owned to the total number of Rarity 99s. Notice that this fraction also represents the completeness of your collection. So if your collection is 50% complete, then you have a 50% chance of completing a single quest. We'll call this ratio R, and it will show up in every formula from here on out, so it's important to understand what it represents. R represents how complete your collection is, and it represents your chances of completing a single quest. We'll use R to calculate the chances of completing some number of quests in a row. For two quests in a row, we take the chance of completing the first quest times the chance of completing the second quest, and we get R squared. For three quests in a row, we multiply by R again to get R cubed. Following the pattern, we can see that our chances of completing n number of quests in a row is given by R to the n. For Illusion, we need to complete 16 quests in a row, and for Jidora, we need 23. You might have noticed that I use the same R value each time, which assumes your collection stays the same for every quest. Realistically, you wouldn't wait to replace each item before moving on, so your collection would decrease by 1 after each level. For the exact formula, we'll go back to the fraction of rarity 99's own divided by total rarity 99's, and we'll assign variables to each part. As you work your way through the quest, the numerator would decrease by 1 every time you use up an item. So the exact formula for completing some number of quests in a row would look like this, which simplifies down to this, which is not an easy formula to work with. And as it turns out, the difference in accuracy is extremely small for collections below 95% complete. So if you want to know your chances of succeeding on a single run, this R to the N estimation works just fine. But we are more interested in our chances across multiple runs. Specifically, we want to know, on average, how many items will be used to get a level 50 prize. This includes any items used on failed runs, since those also eat into your profit margins. To answer this question, we'll treat each quest like a coin flip. Heads means we have the item, and tails means we don't. So the question of how many flips will it take to get n heads in a row is the same as asking how many quest attempts it will take to complete n quests in a row. Luckily, there are many resources out there that have already explored this problem for coin flips, so we can jump straight to the answer here, where P is the probability of landing on heads, and N is the target number of heads in a row. We'll let capital N represent the number of quest attempts for a level 50 prize. Then we can rewrite that coin flip formula using our questing variables. So the chance of landing on heads becomes the chance of completing a single quest, and the target number of heads becomes the target number of quests to complete. Next, we'll use this to figure out the actual number of items used during all those quest attempts. Since we don't use up any items when we fail a quest, we need to subtract off the number of failed quests from the total number of attempts to get the actual number of items used. We just figured out the total number of attempts, so we can replace that with a capital N. And the expected number of failed quests would be the chance of failing a single quest times the total number of quests attempted. Since there are only two outcomes for each quest, the chance of failing is just 1 minus the chance of success. And we already know how many attempts it'll take, so there's another capital N. Now that we've got everything in terms of variables, we can do a bit of algebra to simplify the expression. Finally, we'll write out capital N in terms of R and little n, which gives us the formula for the average number of items used to get a level 50 prize. We'll use capital E to represent this number. We are now ready to calculate our average profit. The profit formula is just money made minus money spent. The intermediate prizes are pretty cheap, so all of your NP made is going to come from the level 50 prize. The NP spent is the total cost of whatever items you use to get that prize, including items used on failed runs. This is what we calculated in the previous section. Writing this equation using variables, we'll let capital I represent the value of Illusion staff, and the cost will be the number of items used times the average cost of a rarity 99 item. Rewriting E in terms of R and N gives the final form of this equation. Notice that this final equation has only one variable, and that's R, which represents the completeness of your collection. The other three letters, I, N, and A, are all constants with known values. So let's fill them in. Currently, ice staffs are worth about 35 mil. I'm going to estimate an average cost of 500k for rarity 99s. Notice that I'm writing it in terms of millions to keep our units consistent, and we need to complete 16 quests in a row. This equation lets us plug in a value for the completeness of our collection and spits out the average profit we should expect from each ice staff. Repeating these steps for Judora's quests, the Wand of the Dark Fairy is worth about 45 mil, the average price per item stays the same, and now we need to complete 23 quests in a row. We can graph these two equations to see how our average profit for each fairy changes as our Rarity 99 collection grows. The green line represents Illusion's quests, and the purple represents Judora's. The x-axis represents the completeness of your collection, and the y-axis represents your average profit on each level 50 prize. The x-intercepts show the cutoff for profitability. You can begin expecting a profit from Illusion when your collection is 86% complete, and a profit from Judora at 90% complete. At 95%, the profit margin is equal for both quests, and after that, Judora's becomes more profitable. Keep in mind, this is all assuming you don't receive any help at all. In reality, each charity corner brings with it more accessibility to Rarity 99s, and more collectors willing to give free help to anyone they see. Until one of those two factors goes away, you can go to the trade chat and quest yourself a level 50 prize without ever owning a Rarity 99 yourself. Basically, I'm saying this whole video was kind of a waste of time because you no longer need to have a collection in order to be a successful quester. But just in case anything changes in the future and collecting becomes feasible again, here's that formula.